What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating a GPO to enable your PowerShell and WinRM within your infrastructure. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is open up your group policy management, and within group policy objects, I'm going to right click on that folder and I'm going to click on new. And for our new GPO, I'm going to give it the following name, computer, because that's what we are tackling, the computer node, and PowerShell and WinRM policy. Pretty simple, right? We're going to click OK there. We're going to locate our new GPO, right click on it, and then click on edit. And the first thing that we need to do is go inside computer configuration. Within computer configuration, we need to open up policies, open up Windows settings, locate security settings, and within there, locate system services. And the first thing that we need to locate is Windows Remote Management, WS Management. So double click on that. We're going to enable it. So check off define the policy settings and then set the services to automatic and then apply it and then okay. Now, next thing that we need to do is go inside Windows Firewall with Advanced Security. Within there, open up Windows Firewall with Advanced Security and we're going to click on inbound rule. We're going to right click on that. Click on new rule. We're going to do a port. Click next here. We're going to specify a local port of 5985. Once we do that, we're going to click on next. We are going to allow the connection. Click next here. This is up to you where you want to apply the rule. Click next. Give it a name. It's up to you. I give it the following a Windows Remote Management. Open and close parentheses of HTTP-in and click finish. All right. Next thing that we need to do is go inside the administrative templates folder. Within here, we're going to open up Windows components and we're going to locate the Windows PowerShell folder. And we need to enable the following, turn on script execution. Double click on that. We're going to enable it. And for the execution policy, we're going to set it as allow local scripts and remote sign scripts. So apply it. Okay. Next thing that we need to do is locate your Windows Remote Management WinRM folder. And within here, we're going to go inside the WinRM client. And within this folder, we're going to locate allow basic authentication. Double click on that. We're going to make sure it's disabled. So we're going to apply it. Okay. Now, the next one that we need to do is allow encrypted traffic. So double click on that. And we are going to disable this one. Apply it, okay it. The next one on the list is disallow digest authentication. So double click on that and we are going to enable that, apply it and okay it. We need to locate trusted hosts. So double click on that one and we are going to enable it. And for your trusted host list, this is up to you, but I'm gonna keep it super simple within my lab. I'm going to give it the asterisk, apply it and okay it. Now we're going to go inside the WinRM service folder. And from here, the following settings we need to configure. We need to locate allow basic authentication. So double click on that. We're going to disable this one, apply it, okay it. The next one on the list is all about the allow remote service management through WinRM. So double click on that one. And we're going to enable it. And for your IPv4 and your IPv6 filter, I both did asterisk, but you are able to give, you know, IP addresses within your environment. For my lab, straight asterisk for me. Click the apply, okay. And the next one is allow encrypted traffic. Double click on that. We're going to disable that, apply it, and then okay it. Once you do all those settings, close it. And next thing that we need to do is just apply it. So for me, I applied it within my server OU because I want to manage my servers using a lot of PowerShell and push out a lot of PowerShell scripts, but it all depends on you. I actually linked it to my server OU and that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.